Ramzan knows that Dalida is looking to rush out to save his sister and tries to talk him down. But Dalida is blind with rage and grabs Ramzan by his throat and screams that if he has to say that he has to save her, that Tita is the world to him. Ramzan manages to get out that Dalida is choking him. Dalida comes to his senses and lets Ramzan go. Algis comes out to add his help for words right in Dalida's face. Algis reminds Dalida of his views on the worthlessness of peasants and commoners. Dalida smashes Algis's face with a punch in retaliation, but it doesn't shut Algis's mouth. Algis tries to appeal to the fact that Algis' nobility and Ramza's nobility, but Dalida's life and friendship isn't worth anything at all, because he's a commoner. Definitely not worth the same as Algis offered friendship to Ramza. Ramza, while restraining Dalida, denies Algis' words and insists that Dalida is like a brother to him. After, Dalida heads off to rescue his sister, and Algis says good riddance to the uppity commoner. Ramza tells Algis to leave the castle immediately. Algis can't believe that a Baloo would side with a commoner. And before Ramza runs him off, Algis tells Ramza where Tita is being held and to take the back route into the hideout. Out in the meadows, on the way out from the castle of Igros, Dalida and Ramza take a moment to reflect. Dalida's singular focus is his sister, and Ramza tries to reassure him. Dalida admits how he felt second class in the castle and with Ramza's family. Ramza, rather oblivious, thinks that Algis' actions are causing these thoughts. Dalida changes the subject, with his thoughts too dark, recalling the time when Ramza's father, not their father as shown here, but Ramza's father in other translations, taught them to use a piece of grass to make a whistle. They both pluck grass and play their reeds as the sun sets. The cadets are sent to Thieves' Fort to finish off the Death Corps. There we encounter a local leader of the dispossessed soldiers, Muluda, who is the sister of Death Corps leader Wigraf. During the battle, Muluda brings up the point how all the peasant soldiers who return from the war are poor and starving. But Algis, being a man who has nothing but his noble birth, goes hard in on how the nobles are superior and how it's the will of God for the peasants to serve the nobles. After a short battle, Muluda is expecting to be executed by Ramza and the cadets. Of course, Algis wants to see her die and yells for Ramza to execute her with his bare hands. The leader refuses to believe that Muluda is an animal and deserves to die. Algis sees this as a betrayal of him and Ramza. Not waiting, Muluda swears that Ramza is horrible for the mercy he is showing and limps off. Meanwhile, back at Igros Castle, there is an attack and Tita, Dalida's sister, is kidnapped. They also try to kidnap Alma Baluv, dragging her out of the castle. But Zalbag, her brother, rushes out and one-shots the kidnapper. Alma is okay and is worried about Tita. Zalbag seems unconcerned. That thought is put aside as the eldest brother, Dystark, stumbles out, holding his side, injured during the attack. He swears revenge on the kidnappers before collapsing in his siblings' arms. Dystark, while in bed recovering, explains that the scouts have found the Death Corps hideout and are going to attack it. Soon the horror deal will be over, but there is no mention on how they are going to help Tita. Ramza speaks up as well, asking if they are going to leave Tita to her fate during the attack. But Dystark reassures his younger siblings that Tita will be returned before the attack. Dalida, with his only living family in danger, is found by Ramza outside the castle. Ramza knows that Dalida is looking to rush out to save his sister and tries to talk him down. But Dalida is blind with rage and grabs Ramza by his throat and screams that he has to save her, that Tita is the world to him. Ramza manages to get out that Dalida is choking him. Dalida comes to his senses and lets Ramza go. Algis comes out to add his help for words right in Dalida's face. Algus reminds Julita of his views on the worthlessness of peasants and commoners. Julita smashes Algus's face with a punch in retaliation, but it doesn't shut Algus's mouth. Algus tries to appeal to the fact that Algus' nobility and Ramza's nobility, but Julita's life and friendship isn't worth anything at all, because he's a commoner. Definitely not worth the same as Algus offered friendship to Ramza. Ramza, while restraining Delita, denies Algus's words and insists that Delita is like a brother to him. After, Delita heads off to rescue his sister, and Algus says good riddance to the uppity commoner. Ramza tells Algus to leave the castle immediately. Algus can't believe that a Baloo would side with a commoner. And before Ramza runs him off, Algus tells Ramza where Tita is being held and to take the back route into the hideout. Out in the meadows, on the way out from the castle of Igros, Delita and Ramza take a moment to reflect. Delita's singular focus is his sister, and Ramza tries to reassure him. Delita admits how he felt second class in the castle and with Ramza's family. Ramza, rather oblivious, thinks that Algus's actions are causing these thoughts. Delita changes the subject, with his thoughts too dark, recalling the time when Ramza's father, not their father as shown here, but Ramza's father in other translations, taught them to use a piece of grass to make a whistle. They both pluck grass and play their reeds as the sun sets. The cadets are sent to Thieves' Fort to finish off the Death Corps. There we encounter local leader of the dispossessed soldiers, Muluda, who is the sister of Death Corps leader Wegraf. During the battle, Muluda brings up the point how all the peasant soldiers who return from the war are poor and starving. But Algus, being a man who has nothing but his noble birth, goes hard in on how the nobles are superior and how it's the will of God for the peasants to serve the nobles. After a short battle, Muluda is expecting to be executed by Ramza and the cadets. Of course, Algus wants to see her die and yells for Ramza to execute her with his bare hands. The leader refuses to believe that Muluda is an animal and deserves to die. Algus sees this as a betrayal of him and Ramza. Not waiting, Muluda swears that Ramza is horrible for the mercy he is showing and limps off. Meanwhile, back at Igros Castle, there is an attack and Tita, the leader's sister, is kidnapped. They also try to kidnap Alma Baloof, dragging her out of the castle. But Zalbag, her brother, rushes out and one-shots the kidnapper. Alma is okay, but is worried about Tita. Zalbag seems unconcerned. That thought is put aside as the eldest brother, Dystark, stumbles out, holding his side, injured during the attack. He swears revenge on the kidnappers before collapsing in his siblings' arms. Dystark, while in bed recovering, explains that the scouts have found the Death Corps hideout and are going to attack it. Soon the horror deal will be over, but there is no mention on how they are going to help Tita. Ramza speaks up as well, asking if they are going to leave Tita to her fate during the attack. But Dystark reassures his younger siblings that Tita will be returned before the attack. Delita, with his only living family in danger, is found by Ramza outside the castle.
Alright. Hello, I'm King Mob. I'm going to be playing Final Fantasy Tactics PS1. Wanted to do a little bit of a recap. Fortunately, I did it live, so a little bit rough. We're going to roll from here. But, glad you liked the recap video. Yeah, I got to do recaps for the other three episodes that I've already done. At least let you recall what's going on in the story. Excuse my drinking here. Parched. All right. don't think so, then I'll definitely continue. I'm going to try to do it in more than one take, but I'm just so busy these days. Had all of a half hour to get things to get that done. So, what I could. Good thing about this game is I don't need to be hovering over the keyboard. Sit back in my chair and relax with my. Once again, the cameras and the flickers. I have to do this again. Oh, you finished Portal that quickly? Wow. It's craziness. Flickering them. But no, I appreciate the thought about the raid. But as I've mentioned before, I enjoy people watching my stream, but I'm not here to try to get subs and pubs. And, wow, my thing's dark. Let's rely on that. Okay, so when we last left, the leader and Ramza left Castle Igros Castle, to try to rescue Delita's sister, Tita, before they make an attack on Igros Castle or Zekida. So I'm going to try to make my way through these, the back way, through this, I assume, valley. Plateau and the valley up in the mountain. So, I'm going to see what happens. Okay, right onto a story mission of some sort. You know, one of these is going to be not really a story mission. Might be it. You're rolling. Yeah, one of these is going to be a monster recruiting mission, I'm pretty sure. But I think the other two are main story. Oh, no. It is a normal battle. Oh, this battle's tough, too. Block 2, no way out. Autograph system. Forget it, we might as well surrender. I'd rather die here than take him prisoner. Besides, if we get caught, we get executed. Fighting is the only way out. Defeat Maluda. High mage and a black mage. Two black mages. Why did you hide Tita? Tita? You mean that Baloo? The Bull Girls took hostage? She's my sister. She has nothing to do with them. pointless to hold her hostage. Please return my sister. What about you? You nobles give us back all you took from us? And they ask you to return what you took from us in the first place. No, you keep taking, forcing us to retaliate. Just give up. There's no reason to return her. He is fast. Oh, yep, they got high ground. Oh, God. Just keep increasing your speed. Beautiful. You should go fast. Yeah, that particular staff heals instead of Bruce. You can do that. Attack with your... Okay. Nice, you're going to take that. Throw a stone. Knock this mage back. No luck. We'll take the 20 damage. There she's different looking. Notice how she has the white cloak and the red shorts. Hoping I can get her. Yeah. Here with this, it's gonna do 84 damage. Hopefully confuse her. Oracles. I think they kind of bad decision, probably. Oh, that was a lot of damage. Marisha is down. The ice actually went off. Wow. Never seen that. Get inertia back up. This. And a good amount of hit points, too. I wish the computer understood what the objectives were.
camped out now, not during the Novolution. The Death Corps soldier, I'll never run away. Put the sword away, Maluda. We're no use fighting any longer. Put down your sword, stop fighting and talk. There has to be a solution to this. Let's find it. I'll talk to my brother. No, I'll talk to Lord Larg. Trust me. What a tricky smooth talk. I'm sick of your lies. I'm not lying. He's really low on hit points. Good. We're big time outnumbered this time. Big revolution. Is revolution necessary? Is it her fault? Are we making you suffer? What's the problem? Ignorance itself is a crime. You only think what you think is right is only what you can see. That's not everything. Not your fault. But I'll keep blaming you until there's a change. As long as you're Baloov, you're my enemy. Yeah, Ramza doesn't really have any sort of understanding of this nation. Enough damage to kill it. Keep them out of death down in the middle. Brother, I'm sorry. Why? What went wrong? Damn it, who the hell am I? Who? To get her to surrender, but just not in the cards. What could Ramza really do? Talk to Larg or Genghis? Others are. I gotta save real quick because I forgot to turn on my cheats. I am too old to grind cheats. Just killed Wigraf's sister. That's not good. But imagine. Like a never ending cycle of revenge, right? That big snap reset button. And come back in here. Right back in. Crux of the matter, if you haven't seen the previous episodes, is the fact that Wigraf and Maluda are peasants who
served as soldiers during the 50-year war. And, you know, with given promises by the nobility, if they served, they would be rewarded. Only to come back and get nothing. Denied everything they were promised. Cast to the outskirts and homeless. And you know, the story really hasn't changed in modern times. After a story mission, sometimes the shops refresh. Look at that, Mage Mesh. Ooh, other hats. None of those. Either. Pretty sure that's new. Chainmail vest. So robes are new. Nothing new there. Okay. Let's try to go to Igros Castle if I can do a battle. We'll see. Well, there's a battle. This Igros Castle should have new stuff as well. This is about Huntress the Lancer. And Bill the Archer. Joe the Monk. God Puncher. Two. There we go. We're at max capacity. Let's do it. Dahlia Plains. Only one? No. It's gotta be some more to the left. Sprint out there and bring him. Made it out. Wall out there too. Don't really have spell points, but we can do this at least. Didn't miss. Good. Oh no, six damage. Big old tackle. Bogeys for Joes. Get out there. Get to go. Wait it out. Ah, let's see if this goes off.
properly? Yeah. Right over Chuck's head. That goblin's way out of position. Good thing you can do is that monsters you can always kill. 48% chance with that. Charm. Hopefully you give us control. Comet Punch. You do get poison me. Yep. That's fine. It's not going to be going on long enough to do anything. Old Joe's going to punch through the mount. It's 216 damage. My god. 360 damage. Oh my god. Horrifying. Always be doing an act. Barely scratched, but that's job points. I'm poisoned. Shoot me anyway. I'll be fine. Ooh! I could take 75 hit points. Comes from this. That level still goes up. Care of that problem. 1, 2, 3. And you can see how little gold you get. The idea of grinding in this game. I'll gladly pass. Hey, mithril sword. Oh, good, battle axe. Overbone, nice. Quite a few good things. I went back here. For bronze shields. Chain mail. Chain shirt. Chain mail. Cool. Right. Circle formation. I like the idea of her punching. Shield and a battle axe. I need to learn this like what I can. Yeah, man. I'm never gonna use it. Step along the way. Becoming a two weapon knight.
always love fighting with you. Favorite thing to do in LARP. Of course, I wasn't as ambitious as my friend Hippie. Bought long sword hand axe. That was a fun one. Sword in my left, sword in my right. I'm going right handed. Let's change that. Ninja. Swords, heck yeah. I'll only be here for a little bit. How the monks can punch people alive. I think I'm going to send those final class. Maybe I'll make him a deal master. Deal master summoner? I don't know yet. I'll figure it out when I get there's good where everybody's at. Also with a few people who are still suffering and dealing with the horrific, non-regulated. What skill I'm gonna give you? Quite yet. Don't know yet. Give you skill. You're kind of. To walk on one. Put some thoughts into this final class. I didn't really expect to get through this early, since normally you can't. You can't get through all the classes in Act 1. I'm looking forward to putting that off later. That's real close. He just lasted all the.
this. Have him with a two-handed bow. Bows use have better range. I need to take him out. He needs to come up. He's gonna stay up. Everybody's ready. Next story. Maybe I was wrong. You kidnapped a girl. We need a hostage to escape. Later, but now they knew stealth and death work lost most of their men, scouted by the Hokuto, our northern lights, northern sky knights. He was our only ace in the hole that up. This is his escape. What are you even thinking? Escape fought sooner or later. We must make it so our children don't have to go with what we did. Small stone may only make a small ripple at first, but someday it'll be a little. Even if we have to rust away here, bad translation, even if we have to throw away our lives here. You'd have us die? Not in vain. Take as many of the nobles with us, with you as possible. Ludicrous, we'll die like dogs. Still be survivors of Fort Kazikadin. You join them, you may get something. Probably dead already. What? Aluda killed? Aluda! Matter of time before the squad gets here. What do we do? Alright, retreat. You heard it, Belgris. Go to Fort Kazikadin. Leave the girl here. They're here! A Hokuten, they're here! Hokuten. Bam, ready? I'll stop them here. Golgoros, you head for Vort Zikadin with the others. Not going. No way I'm gonna die. Hey there, Salami. How's it going? Okay, we have a capacity for 4. With us, Thief. Bring in Rodgarios. He's peeking in here. Bring in our Ninja Lord, Satan. Satan's gonna be murdering people. Windmill Shed. It was you. Did you kill Maluda? It was you cadets who killed my sister. It was McGrath's sister? Well then, I have no choice. I'll avenge my sister. All good here. Ready for tactical menace? Excellent, Rygar. Rygar slash the breathing salami slash. I forget all your names. Straight up and goon. Here you go.
Boko, the Chocobo. Good tackle. Tita back. Oh, Tita, that girl. You're a Baloov? I believe I am. Old girl says wrong. He is with you, correct? Doesn't matter who you are. Have his sister. Correct me if I'm wrong. The way the girl was to be released anyway. Had no intention of keeping her. First things first. If you want the girl back, you'll have to beat me. Sword down. No need to waste lives. Why did you kill her? Why Maluda? No intention of killing her. Other ways of fighting. We talk. I don't understand what you're saying. What is talking to you? You make something happen even if you wanted to? But even if you did, your brothers wouldn't allow it. Brothers don't want to fight. Figure if you put the sword down, they'll listen. Ha! That's absurd. Your brothers don't want to fight? So deluded. Oh, a holy sword. There's that sword magic. Crush punch, 70 damage. Whew. What's the problem with being a ninja? Cannon. Oh, good. Low damage. Good dodge. Probably gonna murk him anyways. Oh. Shove there. My brothers like to make battle. Oh, you're so green. All leaders' hands. My star, a sense of justice. Justice must mean different things to different people. How dare you insult him? Kids are kicking. Oh, I'm both of them too. Oh yes. 126. Stop. Rygar's turning it out. Tough one, eh? Luda, sorry, but I can't die here. Wait, Rygar's running away? Who do you think Gustav had kidnapped the Marquis? Who do you think had Gustav kidnapped the Marquis? Your brother Dystar. I'm sure Zalbag knows too. But ridiculous, why would he do such a thing? Two lions are fighting power. The white lion are. And there's black. Want to know who their allies are? Aren't these strangers' lions? Not kill them all and bring in your own people. Gustav was deceived by Dystar Silkcom and kidnapped the Marquis. Lies, a Baloov would never do such a thing. See for yourself. Bye, Baloov. Newgraph, take that back! Meanwhile, Satan's dirt napping. Tita, where are you, Tita? fighter anywhere. Tita, where are you?
Ref lied.
Of course, Rams is asking the wrong question. Lita, let's go to Zeke. Zeke. Okay, I can adjust that. Thank you there, Reading Salami. Yeah, let's try that. Dude, let's go to Zeke then. Tita must be there. What happened? What went wrong? Tell me, Raptor. Why did this have to happen to Tita? Check information. Yet, yes, you are. Okay. I'm definitely gonna have to get Chuck a counter match. Dare attack Chuck the ground beast. What? Master. Actually, you're good. Reflex. Good. I think you're gonna stay as. But. I don't know what the Reading Salami is going to be. Like this final class. We'll peek around. All these classes, we don't actually have the weapons of the samurai. Vanish. You hit, you turn invisible. That's hilarious. Okay, back to towns again. Joppin'. Nothing new. Sometimes they have different. Oh, I can start doing bar stuff. Forgot. Oh. revealed the main group of the Death Corps would be close to annihilated. Four groups of the full number of thieves apprehended to the plan of 700 death total approximately. Vigraf, leader of the Death Corps. Get Vigraf ahead. I can't do far missions yet. Just fine. Go quick save. Evade a physical attack. Possible. Kind of. God. Okay, go for it. Oh, got a random mission. Be black and stone. I know he's broken. Pippi needs to go in. Marsha as well. Ask her. Anybody lower? Okay. My friend recommended this story to me that you need to check out. Basic idea premise starts with that they get a whole bunch of people together to try to brute force the names of God. If you're wondering what I'm talking about, look up the 42-letter name of God, or the 72-letter name of God, or the 216-letter word of God. And it kind of goes from there. Working a cubicle job all day, trying to guess God's name so your CEO can meet with them, hobnob with them. Pretty bleak stuff. Two chickens, two cats, and a dragon. Ha! Started. Dragon. Chicken just move. Chicken's gonna get combat punch. Hit it with it. Full attack. Earthquake. One shot. Haste going here. Do first though. Move a place where I can get multiple people at the base. Yeah, I'm having spells missed for no reason. Her life, I think. Bunch of That's gonna hit her.
Air effect. Goblet punch.
Take the Huntress for a name for that. Damage. It'll start regenerating. Oh yeah, this is gonna be a mess. Chicken, 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 chicken. Yes, we're gonna fry that chicken. Bye, chicken. It doesn't make the earth eat you. Yeah, I don't even think it uses the ability to use MP. It's ridiculous. It's half your hit. Demi does.